cave of Eliyahu Navi. So when Rabbeinu was in the cave of Eliyahu Navi, Rabbeinu thought to himself, here in that cave, Eliyahu Navi was doing his Buddhist. He was spending a lot of hours here alone with Hashem, and he was talking to Hashem, and he was praying to Hashem. And Rabbi Nathan said that he realized that the meaning of Rabbeinu by telling him that story was to say that all of what Eliyahu Navi achieved was by that, by talking to Hashem Yitbarach. And you see that in other books also. A lot of books are calling it also Yitbodedut. But not all of the books. In a lot of books of Mikubalim you can see that. And also the Ramchal is writing on that in Mesilat Yesharim and in Derech Hashem. Explains how it person needs to. Shulchan Aruch you can find it. Rabbi Yosef Karo was doing Yitbodedut. Hafetz Chaim, all of the tzaddikim. You cannot do Mitzvot HaTshuva without doing Yitbodedut. Mitzvot HaTfilah, you cannot pray to Hashem if not pray to Bodedut. Just Rabbeinu called it Bodedut. What it means it Bodedut? To be alone with Hashem. This is it. And to talk to him. It's Mitzvot HaTfilah. This is why I'm trying always in the classes to say Mitzvot HaTfilah, Mitzvot HaTfilah. Because it can sound hard for a person to hear it Bodedut, it Bodedut, it Bodedut. We're not asking you to do nothing special. It's just to spend time alone with your Creator, the one that brought you to this world, the one that you believe in Him, just to believe in Him. How are you going to do this without talking to Him? And when you talk to Him, it's written, "Emanti ki adaber." David HaMelech is saying, in Halel we read it, "Emanti ki adaber." I believe because I'm talking. If you're not learning Torah and talking words of Torah, if you're not talking words of Tehillim and praising Hashem, and you're not praying and talking words of Tefillah, how are you going to believe? Only when you pray and you've been answered, you say, hey, that's an evidence that there is Hashem. If you never try to pray to Hashem, so you can never be answered. So how are you going to know that it works, that Tefillah works? You need to try. So this is what once I heard Rav Shalom that he said about Pesach and that how come Am Yisrael saw so many miracles that they had when they came out from Egypt in the Yetziat Mitzrayim story, and it didn't help them. After all of the miracles, the sea been opened for them and all of the 10 Makot, they saw a lot of miracles over there, and after it they keep on whining and complaining and arguing. And why the miracles didn't help them? Because they didn't pray enough. When a person sees a miracle, but it's not out of his prayers, out of his tefillot, he just received it, it's not building your faith. But when you pray on something, it brings you to such humility, because you see, you couldn't achieve that thing without prayers. And now after you prayed, that was the only thing that changed reality, that brought the good result to happen. So you see that it was depends on your prayer, so now you see that it's a shame. That's how Rav explained the Mishnah, Yagata Umatzata Ta'amin. If you put an effort and then you found, it's going to bring you to faith. You're going to believe. You're going to see that it brought you to faith. But if Lo Yagata, you didn't put effort, you haven't prayed on it, and you found, Lo Ta'amin. It will not going to bring you to faith, you are not going to believe. Why? Because, okay, it's a coincidence, I was lucky that day, Baruch Hashem, amazing things happened. Interesting world, a coincidence. But when you pray, you see that you're naked, you're hopeless, you don't have... Just Hashem can help you. And you say, please Hashem, and then you see a miracle. So you know for sure Hashem saved me. Yeah. But for that you need to try that.
You have to make it clean.
Yeah. When you say that, feel all that is what the words of God. Kelim and Kabbalat Hashem are the vessels to contain the bounty. All kinds.
You make yourself a better person to be able to hear. That's what you do. You change yourself by prayer.
Yes, because we cannot. And if a man even accepts himself, okay, I want to be a better person. Rambam is saying in Chot Shuva that you need to accept on yourself not to sin anymore. How can you do that? Let's say now, okay, we're never going to be angry again. It's a joke. You're not able to do it. Even you accept it, you saw it was wrong, it's not good, it damaged your life. You cannot decide, even if you will try. So what the Rambam made it impossible for us. cannot be. Have to have a certain way to keep that halakha of tshuva. Mm-hmm. So you need to accept on yourself, to be mekabel on yourself something. What? To turn it. To work on it. To work on your attributes, on your midot. To pray. How are you going to work on them? To pray. Every day you pray. And the Gemara is saying that Yetzirah is stronger than a person and wants to kill him every day. And if Hashem will not going to help him, to the person, so we cannot conquer his Yetzirah. Mm-hmm. So what you need to do? You need to call Hashem. You need Siyat HaDeshmaya. You need to call him over.
Call a friend.
Call a friend. Speed dialer. Ask him from the dialer box, or WhatsApp, or
the bat phone.
And it's also free, you know? It's a free call. A free call to heaven, so... מה, אתה רוצה לעשות זימן?
מה זה זימן? לאן?
עוד בקבוק לשכן? לבד אתה הולך?
איתי.
Please subscribe and like this video and share it with your friends to help spread faith in the world. For more, please visit emunah.com.